with physics. Because of that, I was not able to connect to Vivek. I guess they are changing something. I don't know. So because of that, I was not able to connect to it. Okay. Now I hope my voice is audible. My voice audible? Everyone out there? Okay. Sorry for the trouble. Now. All right. So today we are going to do a case study. Okay. Jaguars. What do they sell? Yeah, good evening. What do Jaguar people sell? Luxury cars, right? So this case study looks at how Jaguar, one of the world's most prestigious car manufacturers, have been involved in a culture change program to create new ways of working for the 21st century. Okay? Corporate culture reflects the personality of an organization, the kind of culture that prevails in a company. What does that reflect? Tell me. The kind of culture that prevails in a company, what does that reflect? That reflects the, like the kind of organization it is. No, Prabhavati. See, I'm asking the kind of culture that reflects, okay, in a particular organization that proves, the kind of culture that organization might be having, the kind of people, the kind of management they have, right? Personality of an organization. Saying, is my voice okay? See, the kind of culture that prevails in an organization that reflects the personality of an organization. I was saying that I'm increasing the class time by 10 minutes. Fine. Okay. You can quickly get the feel for the culture of an organization. Fine. Thank you. Just by looking around and talking to the people who work for it. For example, some organizations are very dynamic and the people are encouraged to take risks. Others are backward looking and rarely take risks. The culture of the organization provides the meaning, direction and the clarity, the human glue that drives the business to achieve its goals. From time to time, it becomes necessary to change the culture of an organization to make sure that it fits the environment in which organization operates. Is this much clear to everyone? I hope my voice is perfect. Mohammed Irshad, Prabhavati, Kelvin, Asya, KP Ramakrishnan, Abdul Salam, and Dijesh. Yeah. So before we switch over to the next page of this, I would request you people to read this on your own. Okay? Yeah, very good evening, Senthil. We are doing a case study on Jaguar today. This is based on corporate culture, how they actually keep on changing their culture so that they can meet out with the industry needs and they can meet out with their goals as well. Culture has to be changed every now and then because goals doesn't remain the same all through, right? So just read the first part of it. Fine, everyone. Please let me know in the chat box. If you have any queries, just let me know. Or just read this page if you don't have any. Are you people reading it? Senthil, the Jayesh, Abdul Salam, K.P. Ramakrishnan, Asya, Kelvin and Prabhavati? Okay, fine, no issues, thank you. You people were also facing issues today with Vizik? Were you finding it difficult to connect to Vizik? I was facing a lot of issues, I don't know why. Yeah, for some, yes, correct. For me also, I don't know, I was not able to connect. Senthil, I think you have logged in through phone, that could be the reason. Are you done with this page, by the way, Senthil? Okay, fine. Let's switch over to the next page. Now, see, changes in the car industry, changing culture. See, the industry, as I told you earlier, the industry demand is going to change every now and then, what market demands, okay? So based on that, the company will have to change their culture too, so that they can meet with their new goal and customer demands as well. The car industry has changed dramatically. At the start of 20th century, the industry was dominated by the achievements of Henry Ford, who created a manufacturing system that was known as Fordism. In Fordist organizations, the manufacturing system was geared towards creating standardized products such as Model T Ford. Have you ever seen a Model T Ford? Like, what is this Ford? Do you know about Ford cars? And what is this Fordism? What is this Fordism? Does anyone know that? What is this culture of Fordism? Any idea? Anyone out there? Let me tell you what Fordism is, okay? Let's learn about Fordism. No, there is a culture. See, Prabhavati, you were there when I was teaching that, Intel case study. What kind of, what word was there that was specific to this Intel people? What was that culture? We learned about some culture, right, Prabhavati, if you remember. What was that? Prabhavati? What was that? What is that specific word? Here the specific word is Fordism. We also learned about another concept there. What was that concept, Prabhavati? Intel one. What was that, Prabhavati? Tell me, Prabhavati. What was the concept? Who is going to tell me what was the concept? Prabhavati, we learned about something there. Please let me know. What was that? You cannot remember? K.P. Ramakrishnan, you were there as well. What was the kind of concept we learned there? Intel. We have done that yesterday. No. There was a specific word, vocabulary. What was that? No one can remember. I'm giving you 2 seconds. Come on, tell me. Who is going to tell me? No one can remember that. What is that? So, Bhavati, just read that case study again at home and let me know the concept tomorrow. I would like to know from you. Okay, now Fordism. Let's learn about Fordism. The video is there in the chat box. Just see what Fordism is and then I'm going to explain it to you. Are you watching that video? Everyone out there? Fordism? Okay, once you are done with this video, just let me know, please. And then I'm going to explain you what Fordism is. Once you are done with the video, just type done in the chat box. Now let's learn about Fordism, okay? A manufacturing philosophy that aims to achieve higher productivity by standardizing the output using conveyor assembly lines and breaking work into small killed. Can you hear? Me now, Prabhavati, and others. See, Fordism, here they have, you know, laid stress on what Fordism is. Fordism, people used to believe, the under this concept, you need to know, okay? Is it okay now? K.P. Ramakrishnan? Alright. See, as far as Fordism is considered, they actually used to believe that we should cut down the cost at the time of production. For that, they need very efficient workers who were able to understand what is being expected from them. And moreover, if they know what is expected from them, and they can you know, like, finish something within a time limit, then obviously it would be a success. Okay, but later on, you know, many other cars came into industry and they were, you know, more successful as compared to this phone. So total quality management, this concept was being developed in US only, but it was implemented first in Japan. It changed the balance of the world trade and led many companies in the West to rethink their attitude, policies and structure. TQM can only operate when the responsibility and power are delegated downwards to all levels of organization. Okay? Now, responding to the changing demand. So first it was like Fordism. Later on, when, you know, Japanese people implemented TQM, it was more successful. You know, companies which were following Fordism, they were being forced to change their, you know, like, the way they used to see things, the way they used to work, the business principles. As the world became more competitive, organizations had to respond quickly to rapidly changing demand. They could no longer rely on producing standardized products. See, standardized products, Ford used to produce that. And they used to follow Buddhism, but it was the demand in 1920. The demand changed later on. So for that, you know, they have to rethink about their policies, and they have to adapt this TQM, which was first implemented in Japan because it was more successful, right? But how to manage a wider portfolio of associated to that? This demanded the increase. See, if you are just going to focus on, you know, manufacturing. One unique quality of car, and you are putting all your energy to it, will it be a success as like Can you hear? Okay. Okay, fine. Let's go to the next page. Making the change. You cannot force a new culture on an unreceptive workforce. See if